the Emergency Banking Act. Roosevelt closed all the banks in the country and kept them all closed until he could pass new legislation on March 9. Roosevelt sent the to Congress two Emergency Bank Act drafted in a large part by Howard Tubbs' advisor. The act was passed and signed into the law the same day. It provided for a system of the reopening sound banks under the Treasury supervision with the federal loans available if needed. 3/4 of the banks in the Federal Reserve system reopened within the next 3 days. Billions of the dollars in our currency and the gold flowed back into them within a month. This destabilizing the bank system. By the end of the 1933, 4,004 small local banks were permanently closed and merged into a larger bank. Their depositors eventually received an average 46% cent on the dollar of their deposit, and it is common false myth that they received nothing back. Creation of the FDIC and FSLIC. In June 1933, our Roosevelt objection, Congress created the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, which insured a deposit for up to $2,500 beginning in January 1st, 1934. On June 16, 1933, President Franklin D. Roosevelt signed the Banking Act of 1933. This legislation, abandonment of the gold standard to deal with the deflation. The nation went on of the gold standard in March and April in a series of the laws and executed order to the government suspended the gold standard for the United States currency. Anyone holding significant amount of the gold coinage was mandated to the exchange it for the existing fixed price of the US dollar, after which the US would no longer pay gold on a demand for the dollar, and gold would no longer be considered valid legal tender for the debit in private and public contract. The dollar was allowed to float freely on foreign exchange markets with no guaranteed price in a gold, only to be fixed again at a significantly lower level a year later. With the passage of the Gold Reserves Act in 1934, market immediately responds well to the suspension in the hope that the decline in the prices would finally end. Glass-Steagall Act of 1933. The Glass-Steagall Act 1933 was passed in reaction to the collapse of the large portion of the American commercial banking system in early 1933. One of the provisions introduced the separation of the banking types according to their businesses, commercial and the investment banking, in order to comply with the new regulation. Most large banks separate into the separate entities. For example, J.P. Morgan separate into three entities. J.P. Morgan continued to operate as a commercial bank. Morgan Stanley was formed to operate as an investment bank, and Morgan Grenfell operated as a British merchant bank. Banking Act of 1935. The Banking Act of 1935 strengthening the power of a Federal Reserve Board of Governors in the area of credit management tightened existing restrictions on a banks engaging in a certain activities and enlarged the supervisory power of the FDIC. Bretton Woods system. The Bretton Woods system of the monetary management established the rules for the commercial and financial relation among the world's major industrial states in the mid 20th century. The Bretton Woods system was the first example of the full negotiated monetary order intended to govern monetary relation among the independent national states, setting up system of rules in which institutions and procedures to regulate the international monetary system. And the plan at Bretton Woods established the International Monetary Funds and International Banks for Reconstruction and Development, which today is part of the World Bank Groups. And the chief features of the Bretton Woods system were an obligation for each country to adopt a monetary policy that will maintain the exchange rate for the typing its currency to the US dollars, and the ability of the IMF to bridge temporary imbalance of payments.